If you're a Git user, you've probably come across this perplexing saying at one point or another in your life. Branches are just pointers to commits. But what the heck does that mean? Branches are these long chains of commits. So how can something like that be represented by a single pointer? Well, it comes down to just one clever design decision and the surprisingly intuitive way that Git utilizes it. To start unraveling this curious paradigm, we need to first take a deeper look at trees.
Am I supposed to be looking for anything in particular?
No, not those trees. I mean the commit tree. When you start a Git project, you make an initial commit. And after that, more commits build up over time. Then, if you want to start a new line of development, you split off and you create some branches. You do that enough times, and you have something that starts to look like a tree.
Still not looking like a tree, though.
Bro, I thought you were coming inside. But let's take a closer look at the commits themselves, because inside they contain author information, a descriptive message, a unique identifier, and links to file versions, so we know which files are modified by that particular commit. But they also contain a pointer, a symbolic link to the commit that came directly before it. And that little pointer is pretty important. It's what allows commits to form chains. So if we have a Git tree, it's actually more accurate to represent the connections between commits with arrows instead of solid lines, kind of like this. This is actually how Git stores commit history behind the scenes. Each time a new commit is added, it sets a pointer to the commit that came directly before it. And just so we're not doing all theory in this video, you can explore these linkages and get a glimpse of all the other commit data we just spoke about using the log command. Just remember to pass the graph, decorate, and one line flags. Then Git will show you a rudimentary visualization of all these commit chains. It's not as good as some dedicated GUIs out there, but hey, it's built in. But there is an exception to that linking rule, and that's merge commits. Merge commits represent a special type of commit that can have more than one parent. And they need two parents because they act as a bridge between two branches. But the way in which merge commits work is somewhat tangential to this video. So if you struggled to learn Git in the past, you'll find a ton of tutorial videos on this channel. But if you exhaust all of those, and you find my teaching style effective for you, LearnGit.io is an online platform that I created with a lot more material and features specifically for learning Git. In fact, there are a suite of lessons dedicated to branch theory and merge conflicts that you'll probably find enlightening if you're enjoying this video. All right, let's get back to pointers and what they have to do with branches. Well, when we create a new commit, how does Git know where to put it? It could either go, let's say, on top of this branch or on top of this one. We need a way to label these. Maybe the most straightforward method would be to label each commit on the branch like this. Let's say the white branch is main and the blue one over here is a feature branch. Now, this would work, but we need to do a calculation or at the very least add another label to specify which is the latest commit. That way, when a new one is created, we know which one's its parent. Now, this method would technically work, but it's neither clever nor surprisingly intuitive like I promised at the beginning of the video. So let's get a little bit clever. Let's say we only kept a single label per branch. Let's say the latest one. Plus, since these labels always point to the most recent commit on the branch, we don't need this extra marker. Now, each time we create a new commit, we always know who the parent is. Then we just move that label when new commits are added. But what about the other commits on the branch? Well, here comes the intuitive part, and it's so intuitive you might have already figured it out. Since each commit contains a pointer to its parent, to uncover all the commits contained within a branch, all we need to do is just follow the pointers starting from the latest one. Boom, we've identified all the commits on the branch without having to label them individually. And that leads us perfectly back to the hypothesis of this video. Branches are just pointers to commits. People say this because a single label with a pointer to a commit is how Git stores branches behind the scenes. That little guy right there, that's it. When you delete a branch, Git just deletes that pointer. The commits on that branch remain, but now they're essentially inaccessible. Same goes for creating a new branch. All you're doing is creating a single pointer. When new commits are placed on that branch, that little label just advances to point to that commit. So the next time you think about Git, think about all those little pointers holding everything together. Commits point to file versions, branches point to commits, and commits point to each other. The humble pointer. gets unsung hero.